Today I will help Dr. Xiao Hongda to deliver her research work because she is on business trip in China. The title of the presentation is Modeling Color Contrast Using the Seachem O2. In this presentation, I will give the introduction. I will introduce the concept of the simultaneous color contrast and give the aim of this project. And then we give the psychophysical experiment for the color contrast and then the experimental result. And finally give the modeling. The modeling is to predict the Seachem O2 on color contrast. And finally give the conclusion and future work. The simultaneous color contrast is a phenomenon that color appearance change with the change of surrounding color. It has been studied traditionally using a paradise, a concept of a text color, an induction field, and a background. For example, it's like this. So the text color they show the induction field and reference white and reference colorfulness. So So this study normally for the aim of this project is to develop a color appearance model space to predict the simultaneous color contrast. So normally we are using this result to perform the content-based image retrieval. For example, the wallpaper image which have the color background. Why we do that? Because the normally color content-based imagery retrieval, the color is the main content, main feature in the color content in the imagery retrieval. Normally, we're using the color space using the HSV and HSI or C-Lab. But these color space, none of these color space consider the color contrast. Another two color appearance model is Seachem 97 and Seachem 02. These two color appearance model can predict the color appearance under a different view condition. Also the view condition can vary dark to light background. But this model may exploit for the color with more chromatic background, not the color, not with the different color contrast. So the experiment, because this project is aimed to get the color appearance, to develop the color color appearance model and the color appearance color space. Is for the content-based image retrieval for wallpaper. So the experiment setting for the color contrast, we're using this paradigm. So this paradigm combines the induction field and background together. So this experiment setting is similar to a typical wallpaper image, that is means object of interest is surrounded by many others non-uniform colored objects. So in the experiment, the same color is placed on the different color background and is estimated by a group of subjects. So this is the text, in the center, there's the text color. We change the different, we change the different color background and ask the subject to give the evaluation, estimation. So the 10 subjects with normal color vision are selected from the 23 after training to conduct psychophysical experiment to estimate the attribute of each color in terms of lightness, colorfulness, and hue. And this experiment conduct on the 19-inch LCD monitor calibrated with D6519 condition. 30 text color and selected with 16 background include 3 gray shades. The magnitude estimation method is applied to scale each color in terms of lightness, colorfulness, and hue. So all the 30 text color and the 60 background represent a plot in this diagram. So the result, the first is evaluation of subject data. So evaluation of subject data using the coefficient variation values. So in the tables is the mean coefficient variation values for the lightness, colorfulness, hue, respectively, in the different frame. The effect on the lightness, in general, the dark background does make color appear lightly, which is consistent with the finding with the literature, even when reference light and text color are present on the same background. So you can see the figure, the mean lightness response of text color plot against different background with luminous level of C-lab. R equals 30% showing the y-axis, and R equals 70% showing the x-axis for each colored background respective. And the effect on the colorfulness. So the similar to reference right, the reference colorfulness is displayed on the same background with a text color. The estimation of colorfulness seems to be affected largely by the change of lightness level of the background. So you can see that. That means the mean colorfulness response estimate on the color background, so showing the y-axis, where R equals 70, 50, and 30 respectively, plotted against the estimation of the colorfulness on the gray background, where R equals 30%. Another interesting phenomenon is that a very colorful background, sometimes outshining these text color, make them less colorful. Even though the same reference colorfulness sample is applied to all the experiments as exemplified where the colorfulness estimation plot on the background with C-Lab, C-Cro40 with the background with color or orange, where C equals 90. So effect on the hue. The effect on the hue, the color shift to the opponent hue of the background. You can see the small dot is original hue, and the big dot is the the small and big dot. Showing the figure, and that means if the background is red, or if the background is green, the text color sometimes showing the reddish. That means the opponent color can shift to the opponent color of the background. The modeling is evaluation of the CCAM02. The CCAM02 has been designed made for the reflective color on the green background. So this figure is shows the estimation from the CCAM02 against the subject estimation. The prediction of the CCAM02 on color contrast. CCAM02 has a CCAM02 haven't predict the color contrast. On the other hand, PUNT has proposed a solution by modifying the parameter show the equation on the right. This formula, this is the prediction of the CCAM02 on color contrast. In our study, because induction field and background merging together, so lead to the two set of the parameter, lead to the signal of parameter the same as another parameters. Modification is done through the chromatic adaptations response in CCAM2 for a text color. So they just put one part in this function. Is this one? Is this part? So this is the modification CCAM02 on the top, and the original is on the bottom row. So finally, the conclusion and the future work. The conclusion, the effect of the color contrast has been investigated in detail in the study with the aim to develop a color model for the content-based image retrieval. CCAM02 has been evaluated to predict the effect and has shown potential in doing so. And the further investigation is worth doing to further modification and evaluation. Next step also include apply the developed models to company-based image retrieval for wallpaper pictures. So any question I can pass to the author.